goorta aanu markabka noo muuqdo oo uu adigu hirkiisa adoo ishaydu aragto baan doonta weyn ka degnaa labada laasho dheer ayaanu kala fuulnaa. Waa haysanaa dhilabada dhinac baan ka galnaa. Anagoo marka markaan ka dusayno dhimasho iyo nolol baa ku talagalnaa.
Chemical tanker Bao Cecil is on its way through the Suez Canal on its journey to Singapore.
You know what is this?
I think it's some suits, safety suits or something.
Yeah, it's a bulletproof.
In the spring of 2009, its sister ship was hijacked off the Somalia coast, an event which still haunts the crew on the Bao Cecil.
Thank you for that. I'm going to see me, isn't it? And hope that we slip it clear one time. Yeah. No more. So can find my foot. He packed him, was the man. Yeah. Is he shooting a post? Where are you? You're a little massive, soccer, haru.
Captain Jan Ove Fredheim has been at sea for more than 30 years, but this kind of equipment is a first, even to this veteran. The sea route through the Suez Canal and the Gulf of Aden is one of the major transport highways of the seas. Each month, more than 2,000 vessels use this important trading route between Asia and Europe. It is in these waters that the Somali pirates are wreaking havoc. The captain of the Bao Cecil summons his crew to a general meeting to inform and advise about their dangerous journey.
Welcome to this general meeting. If we get attacked, we will sound the alarm. And if the pirates come on board, I don't think it will help anybody to try as Sylvester Stallone or something like that.
20-year-old Nancy is the only woman among the 27 crew members.
I feel more outsat
than those who are on board now, Fredrik and Damer.
It's a gang of guys, pirates, so you don't know what they do. Min mor hun fortalte at jeg skulle kle meg ut som en gutt når vi reiste gjennom her.
Ja, nå er det tre døgn. Da må vi være fullt forberedt på alt.
At the same time, the Norwegian warship Fridtjof Nansen has also arrived in the Red Sea on its way to join the recently established EU task force to combat piracy, Operation Atalanta. Dutchman Peter Bint has the overall command of the 12 warships assigned to patrol and protect a sea area larger than the entire United States.
If Somalia slides off further, also by piracy, that is a security risk for the whole world. 80% of trade of goods and energy is transported overseas. So it is vital for everyone that we fight this threat.
The Fridtjof Nansen is among the newest and most sophisticated ships in the task force. For this occasion, it's been equipped with prison barracks, robotic machine guns, and super-fast speedboats operated by Norway's Navy SEALs.
Jeg synes det var perfekt, for å si det rett ut. Det å få lov til å være sjef på et slikt oppdrag, det å få dra på en ordentlig deployering med besetningen sin og fartøyet, det var fantastisk kjekt.
Og spesielt nå som marinen har vært i en sånn bølgedal, så er det viktig å få sagt at yes, her er vi, og kan levere resultater.
20-year-old Ina has been in the Navy for almost a year.
Jeg tenker ikke så mye på at det er fælt og skummelt. Jeg føler meg veldig beskyttet ombord av menneskene og hele settingen og det at vi har trent. Det er liksom ikke, vi er forberedt på det, som, det verste som kan skje.
Today, she and the rest of the crew will have their first taste of the realities of pirate hunting.
Det som er mistenkelig i seg selv, er når et slikt moderfartøy eller fiskefartøy-sak driver og sleper små joller etter seg. Det er et typisk tegn på at det kan være pirataktivitet.
Det er at den akterste skiffen har satt i bevegelse. Han holder forholdsvis stor fart.
Utkikke, ikke glem å se rundt deg også. Ikke bare følg med på skiffene.
Da har vi vår egen. Det er vår ribb.
Egyptisk flagg. Det er i utgangspunktet et godt tegn. Geit, og se på siste rapporter, så anser denne situasjonen for fallskadene denne gangen. Vi avbryter oppdrag og returnerer hen til planen.
Hardt støv opp.
Vi kan trekke inn.
Mottatt. Det er litt sånn, oi, nå er du på ekte. Nå er vi der. Det du har gått og snakket om i et halvt år. Så det er litt spennende. Litt gøy og litt spennende. Men jo, det kribler litt.
The city of Odessa, Ukraine. From this Black Sea port, cargo vessel Faina set out to sea in September 2008, on its way to Kenya and Sudan.
Внутреннее чувство какое-то вот говорило, что не стоит туда идти.
For the first time, Sergei and his friends talk about their ordeal after they were hijacked by pirates in the Gulf of Aden, an event which triggered the Western naval offensive against the pirates. On September 25th, 2008, the Faina enters the Gulf of Aden, carrying an ominous cargo.
Движущуюся технику, танки, зенитные установки, грады.
Танковые пулеметы, РПГ, и, наверное, какие-то боеприпасы. Когда я работал с правого борта, я услышал неопределенные звонки. Услышал треск автоматной очереди. Я выглянул за борт и увидел, что две моторные лодки.
Было ощущение, что нас уже ждали. Их лодки подошли с моря.
Где-то спустя минут 20, наверное, полчаса, поступил звонок с мостика. Сказали останавливать машину. Вот. В этот момент мы открыли дверь в машину и как бы увидели очень страшную картину.
оружие.
Под дулом, так скажем, автоматов нас завели и сказали: ребят, вы захвачены, все. Мы надеялись на то, что, имея на борту военный груз, наше освобождение и выкуп, это будет очень быстро все. Мы ошибались.
Ja, god dagen, Toren. Det er fredagen på Cecil. Nå er jeg kommet inn i løvens hule.
On board the tanker Bal Cecil, the crew has started their final preparations before crossing the dangerous Gulf of Aden.
Ja. Jeg tenker at... Forhåpentligvis så... Dette er en liten avskrekker. I beste fall et problem for deg.
De kaster godt på seg, og de er tung. Og med piggtrøy i tillegg, så ikke så godt å få på seg.
In addition to the barbed wire and the floating ropes, the captain has decided to extend hoses with boiling hot steam along the sides. The ship will be turned into a floating fortress.
Spørs hva vi får til nå, da. Her ser du, vi har 7 bar på steamen her, altså. Han er varm og god.
Er det ikke bemannet her nede? Ja, jeg vil helst at dere kan svare på telefonen når vi skal ringe til dere. At ikke vi må ringe opp igjen i lengre tid her. Sånn, så er jo vitsen med bemannet maskinen om vekken.
Det er litt anspent, kanskje. Venter på at det ikke skal skje noe.
Har du radio?
Radio.
Jeg er til å fyre deg i gang, sånn du vet det. Han har ikke åpnet enda. Det er jo så vidt det er knept nok åpent.
Er alt fullt åpent på stimen, eller?
Det er ikke stort mer vi kan gjøre med rappumpen. Men da bare trekker du deg inn, du, da, så lukker døra etter deg.
Kommer de, så kommer de. Det er jo ikke mer med det. Men vi har noe prøft.
Så nå er alle klare med at nå er vi inne i den såkalte korridoren. Så. Det er bare å krysse fingrene og håpe på at de passer på oss.
Arif is only 29 years old and already the commander of a group of 20 pirates. Piracy has made him a rich man here in Ail, the city that has been called the pirate capital of Somalia. Off the beach lies Ali's latest bounty, a Filipino ship that he soon hopes will bring ransom.
marka anu wano kala soo caanyihiin oo dadka maaragtay reer galbeedka sida ingiriiska iyo jarmalka iyo danu gacanta ku rigno balan iyaga waxaa naga ah inaanu 3 milyan ka qaadano laakiinse dadka muslimiinta malin 500 hadda filibiin waa ku wareersanay wax naga shiidayaan laanahay oo anagii baa ku daymoonay
The sea outside of Ale used to be filled with tuna fish, lobster, and shrimp. Then the foreigners arrived with modern fishing ships trawling the reefs bare of life.
Ana buuxa burcadbayadan ugu kalifay iyo baahida noo geysay waxa weey marka aan aragnay wax noo qabanaysa in isan jirin.
With their livelihood gone, the population here had no other choice but to turn to piracy, according to Somali human rights advocate Mohamed Waldo.
It's merely a desperate response of a desperate people, of desperate fishermen, of desperate community. It's a desperate response.
In the Gulf of Aden, the warship Fridtjof Nansen has been assigned to escort the Bow Cecil for a few miles.
Adenbukten å betrakte som et av de farligste stedene i verden for sjøfolk. Så ut fra et sånt perspektiv, så har de grunn til å være engstelig.
Litt kjekt at de kunne komme opp og vise seg på siden på oss. De kom i møte med oss.
De har gjort alt riktig. Og de har åpenbart planlagt og forberedt seg godt for en trygg og god gjennomgang.
This is Fridtjof Nansen. Vi ser deg nå, og du ser veldig fin ut. Du holder god fart, og vi ønsker deg riktig god tur videre gjennom området. Over.
Ja, vi har jo full beredskap her ombord. Vi har gått med utkikk og prøvd å gjort våre tiltak så godt vi kan. Så
Du er nå godt passet på hele veien bortover. Så du får ha en riktig god tur, holde oppe farten, og så ønsker vi deg en trygg og god seilas gjennom området.
Jo, takk skal du ha for det. Så får du ha lykke til med deres jakt på piratene videre. Ja, så ser jeg de tar bildet av den fine båten vår også. Det er nå sikkert bra. Hvor lenge de vil gå der og ikke det, er jo sikkert.
Ukrainian cargo vessel Faina barely managed to send a mayday signal before the pirates were on board. In just minutes, the 17 frightened sailors were captured and forced into a tiny cabin of just 12 square meters.
Страшно, что мало ли что этому вооруженному пирату стукнет в голову. Мало ли, сейчас откроет огонь. И все.
Вторые сутки нашего заключения. В каюте ужасно жарко.
While the pirates went through the boat in search of valuables, sailor Сергей Саранча managed to hide his mobile phone.
Опасно было, конечно. Каждый раз прятал телефон. Так, попросил ребята, посмотрите, если кто будет идти, свистните. Я быстренько спрячу.
These are his own video images of their captivity, which was to last for 4 full months.
Вот так вот мы здесь в тесноте и живем. Здесь у нас типа столовый. Черт, уходим, уходим, уходим. Уходим, прикрой, прикрой.
The Faina is taken to the pirate port of Habyo. Meanwhile, an American warship arrives to monitor the situation.
Что, вертолёт? Летает? Наш. Не, не наш, это Black Hawk. Чёрный ястреб.
As the weeks go by, the crew realizes that their shipping company in Odessa is not going to pay the ransom anytime soon. In the tiny cabin, People are starting to get on each other's nerves.
Тяжело было, потому что даже не сами негры, сами некоторые люди в экипаже сами создавали напряженную ситуацию, моральную такую. Надо было смотреть не только, чтобы негры тебя не тронули, а надо было смотреть, чтобы этот человек ничего не натворил. Лично я на тот момент говорил спасибо за то, что я проснулся и ложился, и просил, чтобы на следующий день проснуться. Но надежда была первая то, что родители не дадут этому всему так просто.
In the Gulf of Aden, the weather is gradually improving, making the conditions ideal for small pirate skiffs. A surveillance plane has spotted a suspicious boat. The Nansen gets the assignment.
You're clear to the Kongen Dostebin. For fartøyet inntar gul beredskap. Dette er ikke øvelse.
Nå har vi en situasjon med en skiff, en liten piratbåt med 7 mennesker ombord. Rapporten så langt indikerer at vi har funnet RPG AK-47, kastekroker, og vi har funnet stiger. Det er ikke tvil, basert på de rapportene jeg har fått, at dette er pirater. Men vi kan heller ikke bevise at de har begått noen pirathandling.
Despite the amount of guns and pirate equipment found, EU procedures do not permit the crew of the Nansen to interrogate the suspects. There is no law against carrying guns in international waters, and the evidence might not secure a conviction in Kenya, the country designated to prosecute the suspects in a court of law. Hesitatingly, the Norwegian commander finally decides to let the pirates go.
Hvor stor nedtur er det?
Det er en situasjon som ikke var helt fremmed av at slikt kunne komme til å skje. Fordi at kravene til bevisføring i denne type saker er veldig strenge. Og det forelå altså ikke nok denne gangen til å kunne anholde disse menneskene.
Before they're set free, the pirates get a serving of sandwiches, water and halal chicken.
Jeg har irriterende at vi må la dem gå igjen og sånn, hvis ikke vi ikke tar dem på fersken. Det er for å ta dem, liksom, ikke for oss, så slipper vi løse.
But then something happens. The pirates apparently don't want to leave.
What are you saying?
The GPS is...
Destroyed?
No,
No waypoint.
No waypoint. And don't know the direction.
Waro degeso GPS taa waxaad gashataa boosaso dariiqo waxa weeyaan 161 hal degree.
Da må vi gjøre det for dem. Og da må vi ut med bomberangen, og det skal altså jegerne gjøre, så da må vi dere filme.
Pour moi. C'est des nouveaux pirates. Peut-être la deuxième fois où ils sortent en mer ou bien quelque chose comme ça, la première fois où ils sortent en mer.
Meanwhile, on board the Bow Cecil, the news of the military's latest pirate encounter has struck like a bombshell.
Ja. Det endte at piraten i Arnbuk utenfor Somalia for å seile hjem, står det der. Det er første som slår oss i ansiktet. Og eksperter fra den norske fregatten gikk gjennom bord på sjørøverbåten. Der stilte de inn GPS-en for den pekte ut retningen og ba dem å dra hjem.
Jeg hadde jo aldri tenkt at de skulle
slipper de fri igjen.
Båten er full i våpen. Og ta våpen, gi deg klapp på skuldra og kaffe og kake. Da blir det jævlig feil, altså. Det er snillisme som råder antagelig, jeg vet ikke.
Sembri waxay u badan yihiin ajnabigu inay guriyaha wada xirtaaniin oo meel aanu ka galmayaan weyno markaas waxaan wada eegsanaa xabad xabadaas aan muraayadaha ku dhalaalnaa muraayadaas marka qolka kaptanka waanu naqaana markaan muraayada ku wajahno baanu ka dusnaa hata marar waxa jira aanu maraakiib dagaal aan afka uga galno jaranjarta u ridayno oo nala ka soo tuuro jaranjarta intii badal lagu tuuro la dhaho war naftiina miyaan nacdeen ma isaga tagtaani markaas waxaan inaa biyo iyo nasiiya
A few pirates still end up in the custody of the Western navies, usually in the cases where they're caught during an actual hijack attempt. The crew on this pirate mothership has just been arrested by U.S. Marines. The suspects are transported to the warship's hangar for processing. From there, they're taken to Kenya to face trial. The Kenyans, however, are anything but overjoyed at accepting these prisoners.
We only accept what we are able to handle. In other words, we bite what we can chew.
At the moment, more than 100 Somali pirates await their trials in Kenyan jails as part of a deal that even the country's members of parliament know nothing about.
We have raised in parliament wanting to know the details of this agreement, which is treated as top secret between the United States of America and certain nations of the European Union to provide facilities in Kenya for the holding of the suspect.
The UN has allocated some $4 million a year to help the Kenyan justice system cope with the large number of piracy cases. But the public defenders who represent the pirates still haven't seen any of this money.
Where are the facilities? Where are the funds? I'm representing about 32 pirates of the total of about 120-130 who are already here. And in none of the files have I been given even a penny.
We have fairly functional institutions and they are being exploited by the Western nations who they are not themselves. Take these people into their own countries.
So far, only a handful of pirates has been convicted in Kenya. The whole arrangement casts doubts about the Western nations' seriousness in wanting to combat the Somali pirates, according to writer Loretta Napoleoni.
Why taking them to Kenya? Why not somewhere else? This is the typical shortcut solution governments in the West really like. I don't want to deal with this problem, therefore, I just do the minimum at huge cost for the taxpayer.
Chemical tanker Bow Cecil is halfway through the Gulf of Aden when an alert lookout spots something suspicious.
We have a tanker boat that follows us here on the side.
Maybe it can be some kind of pirate work. So now we have done a little undermaneuver to come as fast as possible away from here. Jeg så sånn, ut som sånn mindre, sånn, uten noe særlig overbygning eller noe særlig.
Du
kjenner
jo bladre nærheten
av den. Nei, men det er jo på noe, kunne være en sånn som så hadde mindre båter om med bord, eller sånne mindre hurtiggående båter.
Hva
er
båten
her? Du legger den og svinger den. Det var noe jævla skutt. Ja, den ändrade kurs mer mot oss än vad den hade från början. Här är det. Här är det.
Og her oppe har vi NATO warship.
NATO warship. This is Bosesset, kom inn. NATO warship in position 13 degrees.
NATO warship, this is Bao Cecil, Lima, Alpha Golf, Uniform 5.
Prøver å kalle på denne NATO warship her, men de svarer ikke dessverre.
Surge in piracy off the coast of Somalia. Here in London, the piracy has created a whole new industry.
We have a new industry of insurance companies, security companies that insure and protect cargoes. It's a big business. As terrorism has become a big business.
If we look at, you know, ransom payments, a sort of conservative estimate for 2008, around 50 million, you can treble that probably to work out the full cost of piracy in terms of, you know, your lawyer's fees, your extra pay to your crew and so on, increased insurance premiums.
And all these additional costs filter down to the likes of you and me, I think, as consumers, as shipping gets more expensive.
Paul Agate, in the company Swinglehurst, is one of the very few insurance executives who agrees to be interviewed about piracy insurance, tailor-made for the situation in the Gulf of Aden.
You know, for insurance costings, it would be paying about maybe $10,000, $15,000, okay, to transit. We were certainly the pioneers in the market, and we received literally tens, dozens of inquiries. So the Christmas card list got suddenly, you know, it went from, let's say, you know, a tenfold increase.
Some analysts believe it's problematic that too many people now are starting to make big money from the threat of piracy.
I don't think that the world population is really interested in stopping the problem of piracy because they do not understand what the problem is about.
Here in Somalia, they think the problem is that foreigners have taken all their fish reserves.
Waxaan soo wajahay maraakiib shisheeye oo khaasatan ka soo jeeda adigu Aasiya, Europe, USA.
Mid ka horta waxay tahay badii wax soo saarkii lahaa oo wax soo saarkii badda oo yaraaday sababna ay u tahay badii oo ay ka shaqeysanayaan dad ajnabi oo maraakiib wata.
If fishermen try to stop this illegal fishing, it's going on in a big way now, under the eyes and nose, and in fact in the protection of the navies.
Pirate Chief Ali Arif recalls the day when he and his father met a large fleet of foreign trawlers at sea.
Hadaanu badi ka shaqeysanayne ama libaxsanayne markaan hunta ku sheego shamaagii waaweynay oo badan noo yaalay oo ala shamaag $100 noogu fadhiday inay naga dalacdaan oo naga jiitaanin idan la'aan hadaanu shamaagii ay naga qaateen oo ayna dhaceen.
Ali's father disappeared in the sea that day.
The choices available to me of being killed by a warlord, being killed by poverty and hunger, and being killed by American bullet, I'd rather the American bullet, and with the chance of winning also something, sometime.
Wa dhacanahay waxba looga ma qabto waxaan uga soo jawaabay hadaan weyna waxaan niri rag baalayn ka dhigay tashada ayaan halka badda ku wajahnay.
The Bow Cecil is still being pursued by a possible pirate boat. The warships, which are here to protect merchant shipping, have failed to answer their distress calls.
Not the warship. Come in, this is Bow Cecil.
No, je vais me ramener mes. Tu vas dire me faire contact, mais rara. Not the warship.
This is motor tanker Bow Cecil.
We have you on IFRS, over.
Yes, we have spotted a little bit suspicious target on our starboard side. Now it is heading towards us.
Let's say that there is a little bit of water. Yeah, blood.
Men det er viktig å se på han at han sitter på sjøen noe, at man hele tiden har kontakt med han.
We are standing in the position on our hill. We are going to
investigate the suspicious bow forest. Yeah, airborne. Yeah, I've set them on helicopter. But it was maybe a little too early, isn't it? It's not like the war is going to come at 8 in the morning and people begin to come to work and so on. It's going to be too early.
But now I see the helicopter coming here on Rodan. There is krigsfartøyet, og her kommer jo et full fart.
Ja, men nå snur han opp også nå. Snur rett rundt.
Han snur det, han stikker det.
Jeg vet ikke å stikke, han kan ikke stikke så langt.
Vi får väl hoppas på att de går ombord och ser vad de har i lasten. Jag tror knappast att det är torsk.
Meanwhile, the warship Fridtjof Nansen also receives a dramatic distress call.
Warship, warship, this is an Italian ship, Southern Cross. It's just under attack, just under attack.
An Italian freighter has come under attack a few miles away. Pirates have opened fire to force it to stop.
One boat, small one, very fast, and use the arm.
Now this is the European warship. I am presently going to send two fast-moving ribs to your position. They will come fast upon your ship.
Det var en vurdering som kontinuerlig gikk gjennom hodet mitt. At jeg håper bare jeg kommer tidsnok. Så var det bokstavlig talt maskineriet på spreng. Vi kjørte med alt vi hadde.
For the moment we have no visual contact of the small craft. Everybody is on the bridge and nobody wants to go out just to have a look over.
Mitt handlingsrom blir kraftig begrenset i det øyeblikket hvor man plutselig står i en situasjon hvor man eventuelt har gisler.
Southern Cross, this is European warship. How are things going with you, over?
Go ahead, please, European. We just see you on our port side.
Vi har kontrollbanene der nå, og ribben er i området vårt. Vi skal bare gjennomsøke skiflimmer, at det ikke er noen umiddelbar nærhet, så begynner vi å søke. Jeg antar at skiflet har prøvd å unnslippe nordover.
Каждый день мы надеялись на то, что вот скоро, скоро, скоро. Но время шло, а мы ничего не знали, ничего не продвигалось.
100 days have passed since the Faina was hijacked. For Christmas, the pirates give their hostages a bottle of whiskey to share among themselves. And this is how they celebrate New Year's Eve 2008.
Whoa. 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 Who
Они себя называют солдатами. Мы солдаты. Вот ваше государство нам деньги заплатит, и мы сойдем.
The pirates have demanded a ransom of $25 million, an amount nobody wants to pay. London lawyer Stephen Askins is hired to negotiate.
The most difficult case that we've been involved in was the Faena. You're dealing with irrational people. It's not like a standard commercial negotiation where you expect someone to start off very high and you start off very low and you perhaps meet in the middle. There are no real rules to it.
The negotiations are at a standstill. One day, the Somalians come to the cabin and order the sailors out on deck.
Сердце ёкнуло. Опять-таки задумываешься, ну всё, пришёл, конец, расстреляют. Ну, пираты показывают, что проходит военное судно американское. Ну и начинают смеяться. Говорят, помашите ручкой, чтобы видели, что вы живы.
Back in the Ukraine, the pirates get the reactions they are after.
Почему мы начали так плотно заниматься этим? Потому что хотели сделать силовой захват. И если бы произошел этот силовой захват, то никого бы не было уже в живых. Ни судна, ни экипажа, никого.
Due to the persistent rumors that the Ukrainian authorities are planning a spectacular rescue operation, the mothers of the hostages decide to start negotiating with the pirates themselves. Svetlana Umgaladze is put in contact with the pirate commander on board the Faena. He calls himself Mohammed.
Он представился как правозащитник. Он произвел, вы знаете, по разговору, он произвел здравомыслящего человека. Вот вроде здравомыслящий, нормальный человек. То есть он как бы бил на то, что они не хотят этим заниматься, пираты. Что вроде бы они хотят работать, как все. И он спрашивал, когда? Когда же наконец-то будет выкуп? Что все-таки люди там страдают?
On the bridge of the Bow Sessel, they still haven't heard any news about the suspicious boat which the NATO warship had promised to check out.
Det har vært spennende å få noen tilbakemelding, men vi har jo følt at tilbakemeldingen er jo av veldig begrenset omfang. Ja, så prøv å kalle den opp igjen. Du som snakket med dem, så kunne det språket. Du får lov til det, hvis du vil.
If you have any information about this fishing boat we reported earlier today.
Yes, sir. That contact has been recognized like a transport though. It was carrying gold.
Can you please repeat once again? He was transporting something?
Goods? Yes, that was transporting gold.
Den var litt suspekt, synes jeg.
Sa han gold?
Gold, ja. Transporting gold. Altså, jeg synes jo den båten oppførte seg litt merkelig. Han gikk noe sånn opp på Kosmos, og så plutselig så begynte han å snu rett sør igjen og sånt. Men vi transporterer jo noe forhåpentligvis fra punktet A til punktet B. Og den korteste veien mellom to punkt er noe en rett linje, hvis ikke det er så langt. Da. Og du færer ikke sånn å kroke og krake, plutselig så går du den veien, og stundet så går du den veien. Da. Men de har noe sagt, vi må jo lite på det, og de har jo investigatet det, så.
Led by a helicopter from the Dutch flagship, the Fridtjof Nansen has set full speed southeast in pursuit of the men who attacked the Italian cargo vessel.
Nå er det piratjakt. Nå driver vi og søker etter denne skiffen, og jeg har gode formeninger om at vi kommer til å finne den, men det kan ta litt tid.
With a head start of just 10 nautical miles, the chances of finding the culprits are good. The prison barracks are prepared for possible guests.
Jeg var veldig fast oppsatt på å finne denne gjengen med forbrytere.
On board the Bow Cecil, the crew has already received information about the attack on the Italian ship and the Navy's up-to-now futile hunt for the pirates.
De har jo helikopter og fly og alt i området, så hvis ikke de klarer å finne den, da tror jeg de skal prøve å finne noe annet å drive med, altså.
Hvordan klarte de å komme seg unna i den situasjonen? Jeg kan bare tenke og spekulere i at denne lille hvite jål har forsvunnet blant bølgetopper og annet hvitt skum i området mens man har flyttet over og prøvd å dekke et stort område på relativt kort tid.
Ship owners, sailors and insurance companies no longer believe that the military can solve the piracy problem on their own.
What we're doing, what I think the European naval forces are doing, is a short-term fix. It's a band-aid.
British security company Hart is one of the many which openly advertise their armed services to ship owners, with the added value of huge discounts on insurance premiums.
Hart provides an armed approach to protection. We are quite expensive, and it ranges from about £120,000 to £180,000, roughly. And it depends on the type of vessel, how long, because the faster the vessel goes, the less time it needs our services on board. But a general rule of thumb is that we are going to be about twice that of an unarmed approach.
Here in the mountains of northern Italy, the security company SIG is arranging a selection course for future sea marshals.
Interessert i lov og orden og sånt noe, på, så passe på, spesielt er veldig patriotisk, så hvis du har muligheten til å hjelpe norske redere, spesielt for min del, så er jeg veldig villig til det, selvfølgelig mot betaling da.
The chief instructor is a former mercenary with extensive experience from work in Africa.
Some of these guys that we have on this course will go down there, are willing to go down there, and we need to prepare them for what they're going to meet. I think that it's just three, four guys on this course that is really up for it to go out there now for a job, yeah.
Ideen er bygge og anlegg i driv, egentlig. Så der er det jo stille og rolig for tiden, så da passer det bra med kurs nå, synes jeg.
Weapons training is an important part of the course. And here is some of the arsenal this company offers its clients.
M4. Denne kan du faktisk også kjøpe sivilt. Den er utrolig fint våpen, 223 kaliber. Den er selvfølgelig da litt modda. Så har vi Dragunov 762. Russisk sniper-rifle. Utrolig fint våpen, hvis de bare kan bruke den. Så skal dere få skyte med en Taiga. 308.
Private security contractors like Torgai Frickson think the international naval forces have lost their credibility because they're reacting too timidly against the pirates. His message to future clients is this.
Yeah, it will be worse. Definitely. There's no doubt about that. I think, personally, a more brutal coalition force. That's the only thing that could stop this.
Some security companies are now running their own private fleets of armed patrol boats outside of Somalia. There is a fear that this trend will inevitably lead to an escalation, also from the pirates.
A pirate was telling me, you know, they do have weapons that can sink most of the vessels on the sea. But they have been reluctant to do it. But if their back is put against the wall, I don't know what they are able to do or what they are likely to do.
In February 2009, a Ukrainian billionaire announced that he would pay the ransom for the crew of the Faina. 134 days after the hijacking, two boxes containing more than $3 million in cash are parachuted onto the vessel's deck.
У них началась дележка. В момент, когда вот привезли уже деньги, съехалось до 50-60 человек.
A few hours later, the pirates and the money are gone. The U.S. Navy moves in with much-needed food and medical supplies.
То есть находиться 134 почти дня в плену, ограничены в движении, так скажем. Ну, так скажем, силы были исчерпаны.
Мы в первую очередь как бы не могли прийти в себя и как бы столько было много эмоций, что даже не знаешь, то ли улыбаться, то ли плакать, то ли кричать, то ли прыгать.
Воспоминания все равно о санкциях. То есть это забыть нельзя. И как бы вычеркнуть из памяти это нельзя, хотя порой очень хочется. Дай бог, конечно, чтобы такого не повторилось больше. В принципе, никому не пожелаешь.
Это кому-то выгодно. То есть хотели бы уже давно это все дело закрыли бы, это пиратство. Просто кому-то выгодно держать их, то и все.
What kind of problems would it create for your company if the piracy of Somalia were to disappear overnight?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it'd be sad in some ways because, you know, we, as I said earlier, we probably enhanced our earnings, you know, by, let's say, 30-35% this year.
After 1 week on patrol, many of the crew members on board the warship Fridtjof Nansen have a new impression of the pirates they have come to fight.
Jeg er litt sånn overrasket av hvor mange det er som har et veldig mye mer offensivt forhold til hvordan disse piratene skal håndteres enn det vi har. Som egentlig ligger ganske langt utover det som vi ville i det hele tatt ha vurdert. Altså.
The crew on the chemical tanker Bow Cecil can finally take a break after a 30-hour nerve-wracking passage through the Gulf of Aden.
Nå rydder vi bare opp igjen etter at vi har gått gjennom Adenbukten.
Jeg hadde aldri tenkt at det kom til å komme opp noe, da, at det skulle komme pirater. Jeg bare tenkte, når ikke du opplever det, så tenker du bare at det er oppskritt. At det ikke finnes. Jeg har aldri tenkt, jeg har aldri sett for meg at det ikke finnes.
The sailors on the merchant ship continue their voyage with mixed feelings about the military and their effort to fight the pirates.
Jeg mister helt trua på nå. Det er veldig trasig for både oss som bor og familiene våre å tenke på at det kan gjerne bli liggende et par måneder hvis det blir tatt. Så vi får håpe at det kan snu det der, men ser ikke sånn ut i øyeblikket, tvert imot.
Jeg er ikke i tvil om hvor min sympati ligger. Den ligger hos sjøfolkene. Jeg er her for å håndheve lov og orden. Men hva som må til for å få orden på Somalia og områdene rundt, det får andre uttale seg om.
Almost 30 Navy ships from at least 16 countries are now attempting to protect merchant vessels from the Somali pirates. And yet, the number of pirate attacks continues to increase.
The cost of, you know, keeping this kind of ships at sea is astronomical. So we have to reinvent, recreate a new way of fighting piracy.
We've seen how pirates are often fed and set free, despite having clear intentions of attacking ships, because of the underlying legal dilemmas facing the multinational naval forces.
It's more political and publicity than actually doing the job. It's not cost effective. It's not productive. It's not working.
The overall solution is on land. What we do at sea is definitely necessary, but the solution is in a stable Somalia.
One thing both the critics and the pirate hunters share is an understanding that before the sailors of the world's merchant fleets can ever start to feel safer, the international community must do something about the conditions in war-torn Somalia. Meanwhile, pirates of Somalia are thriving from the ever-increasing ransoms paid by ship owners. On the beaches of pirate capital Ale, Ali Arif is even considering raising the stakes.
مرنا عالم كده جه واقع غير انتونا مركه وحان هو كلفه يسا نيمان كاسو دي تريدو قالي نغواه ناي قاده خوب كناي قاده ددك نغا افطوبه ان انو ددك ابرينو اما سيدي ودمدي نوغه ري برعد بدنيمده